But it's not that simple. Three former U.S. military officials told us why.
I wouldn't want to gamble on just a limited strike, and that would do it if I was the President of the United States. It would not be one strike and then the second strike. No, it wouldn't happen that way. You'd have to expect a major response from Iran. Well, the United States does overmatch Iran completely militarily, but would it be easy or uncomplicated? We completely overmatched Saddam Hussein, and we lost almost 4,000 men and women dead in that war.
The Iranian military is strong, it's powerful, it's like the eighth largest army in the world, and it must be taken seriously.
Iran, with the vastness of its land, 80 million people, homogeneous population. I know the Zagros Mountains in Iran. I know that terrain. It simply isn't a rock. It's not a desert where you go bomb one tank after another. It would be an incredible feat to defeat anyone inside Iran.
Iran's military strengths are, first, its diversification of its weapons, of its people. They have Shia militias all over the Middle East. Hezbollah is a very significant force. They have a regular army. They are decentralized. They have a regular navy. It would drag other countries into it. Iraq is a Shia-dominated country. You've got a war in Syria, in Yemen, in Libya. So it would be very messy.
We're looking at a war that would spread fairly quickly. We've got elements in Iraq that will side with Iran, elements in Syria that will side with Iran. We've got elements in Saudi Arabia that have just been waiting for the royals to get hard-pressed by something.
If there was to be sort of a conventional conflict with Iran, I don't see anybody coming out of this winning. I mean, we will lose troops, we will lose bases, we will lose ships, we will lose aircraft.